Hey, what's good? I'm Sadia, and in this video I'm going to be reviewing and demoing the Fifine A6T microphone. Is it Fifine, as the name suggests? Let's check it out. So, I didn't film the unboxing, but this is the box it comes in. Pretty nice packaging, I must say. Usually you just get the product in a piece of plastic cover and some cardboard, but this foam is pretty neat. So, you can see the four molds for each item, which basically contain the USB-C cable, the mic itself pre-attached to the shock mount, the desk clamp, and the pop filter, which has a cute smiley face on there. That's basically their logo. It's not really noticeable once the RGB lights are on though. And underneath all of those was the boom arm, if you've got the boom arm version. The overall design is nice, I think it's a good size. I originally went for the HyperX Quadcast S, and it was massive. I didn't like it, so I sent it back and I got this instead. It was much cheaper too, at only $59.99, and that includes the boom arm. You can get the stand only version for $39.99. Honestly, very good prices. As you can see, the mic comes in pink and white too, so you've got options. So I got this one because I was looking for a USB mic that's always connected. I specifically wanted one that has the RGB lights because if you hadn't guessed already, I love my lights. And this one has auto changing lights. I love the blue and purple look. The others are nice too, but I'm not really too keen on the red and green. But there's more to this mic than just looking pretty. The lights are an indicator of whether the mic is on or not. So let's say you're in a meeting or live streaming, but you want to mute yourself for a second or whatever. All you got to do is tap the top and boom, lights off, which means you're on mute. Tap again and lights on, you can be heard. It's a neat little feature. The mesh pop filter is there to help eliminate any hisses or pops. Perfect pretty problem. Perfect pretty problem. Perfect pretty problem. Pop. It's detachable too, but I see no reason to remove it. At the very bottom you've got the gain knob, which you can turn left or right to tweak the sound level or volume from the mic. The shock mount that it comes with holds the mic in place. It does its job. At the back you've got the USB-C port, which then connects to your Mac or PC's USB-A port. I've got mine connected to the USB port on my monitor. What you don't get with this mic is a headphone jack for audio monitoring. You can still do so through your mic or PC, of course, but just not directly from the mic, so it's no biggie really. Moving on to the boom arm, it's very flexible, which I love. I've mounted mine to the side of my desk so that it's out of the way when I don't need it, so it basically takes no desk space at all. When I want it, I'll just swing it my way. I love to keep cables hidden where possible. As you can see, my desk shows none except the main power lead. So what I did is I used Velcro cable ties to run the USB-C to USB-A cable over the boom arm like this. I kept it a little loose to account for any movement, and yeah, it's nice and tidy, at least for me it is. Oh, and the mic is somewhat flexible too. You can loosen or tighten this screw to fit your needs, and then you can position the mic however you want really. It goes up and down and left and right, so that's cool. Fifine, yep, I'd say this is a Fifine mic, but how good is the audio quality? Let's put it to the test. So, let's first compare it to the built-in Max mic. Obviously the Fifine is going to be better, but just so you can hear the difference. Alright, so what you're hearing now is coming from the built-in Mac mic. So don't forget to hit the like button if you're enjoying this video, and don't forget to subscribe for more videos like this as well. So this was the Mac mic, and now moving on to the Fifine. Okay, so what you're hearing now is the Fifine A6T mic. So don't forget to hit the like button if you're enjoying this video, and also don't forget to subscribe for more content like this. And yeah, this is the Fifine mic, which I'm sure you can agree that it sounds way better than the Mac mic. Sounds Fifine. But what about background noise? Since this is a cardioid mic, it's sensitive to the sound coming from the front of the mic, but it definitely doesn't eliminate the background noise entirely. I'll do a keyboard sound test so you can hear how much of it it captures whilst I'm talking. Okay, so I'm just typing whilst I'm talking, and you can obviously hear the keyboard. It's not overpowering my voice at least, so that's the good thing. Okay, now let me just test making a sound all around the mic so you can see how sensitive it is. You can hear the volume is much clearer at the front and less so at the sides and the back. I'll do it again, but this time I'll snap my fingers. Not bad, right? I think the Fifine name is fitting because if you're looking to do voiceovers or stream or anything that doesn't require professional equipment, then this is the perfect budget mic. It's affordable, looks good, and it provides quality audio. Bear in mind though that these tests were done with the mic as it is out of the box. No tweaks were made. You could of course make it sound better by adding filters such as a compressor. You may need to play with the settings to see what works for you, but overall this is a great mic for the price. I would definitely recommend it. I hope you found this video useful. Hit the like button if you did and drop a comment as well. And don't forget to subscribe for more content like this. As always, thank you for watching. Peace.